Juanita Bynum said, God told her to tell 21 people to sow $1,000. Watch this.
21 people in this building that God said will give $1,000. He said, 21 people in this building, come now wherever you are. Give me an envelope. Give me some envelopes. He said, 21 people, come now wherever you are. $1,000 ain't nothing in comparison to what God's going to do. I didn't call for buckets yet, y'all. It ain't nothing. There's promotions that you want. You're not going to get it until you make that sacrifice to God. Line up right here. I know what I'm talking about. Older and younger. I know you in here because the prophecy don't lie. The Spirit of the Lord don't lie. The Spirit of the Lord don't lie. The Spirit of the Lord don't lie. He's not a lying spirit. He said 21 people in here. If God wasn't talking, nobody would have moved. He said 21 people in this building. That's what he means. He said 21 people in this building. How do I know God is talking to me? Because you got it. That's how I know God is talking to you. Because it's in your account right now. Because it's on your credit card right now. That's how I know God is talking to you.
Juanita Bynum said, God told her to tell 21 people to sow $1,000. If I'm not mistaken, 21 times 1,000 equals 21,000. So it would cost 21 people $21,000 to receive a blessing.
And I can tell you with authority that some of these preachers, evangelists, prophets and prophetesses come into town with a negotiated contract that says, you will pay me X amount of money to come into town. You will cover my hotel. You will cover my travel expenses. You will cover my per diem. And half of what I raise, I keep. Imagine that. Half of what I raise, I keep. Y'all, let me tell you something. Just between me and you, don't tell nobody else. I was doing video production for a conference. And there was an international evangelist, preacher. He called himself a prophet. He's popular on YouTube for giving out prophecies. He came into town and he directed the congregants to give $1,000. He told them if they gave this $1,000 that night, that they would receive abundant blessings of different sorts. He went around the room promising people this and this and this, and he said $1 million to this person and $3 million to that person and $1 million, million, million. One brother stood up and dedicated $1,000 from his household. And when I tell you, as I looked through my viewfinder at this brother, his wife stood next to him and looked up at him. He was a tall brother, maybe 350 pounds, 6'5". And his little wife stood next to him and looked up at him as if to say, what in the world are you doing? You know we got bills, you know we got kids. And I looked at this woman through my viewfinder in the camera and I said, oh, bruh, it's going to be hard for you at home tonight. But the preacher was charismatic. He preyed on the emotions of the people. And he got this brother to commit to $1,000 that night. And he probably slept in the garage or in the doghouse when he got home. Ladies and gentlemen, my brothers and sisters, God does not need your money. And I know that may strike some people as strange. It may strike you as odd. You may not like how that sounds, because it's not what you're used to, but an omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent God does not need your little coins to be God. Now, I've given thousands of dollars in church, but understand that it's because I was committed to the ministry, I was dedicated, and I believed in the leadership, and I understood that the ministry needed the money, not God. The church might need your money, especially if you're in a storefront situation where they gotta make rent every month. Or your church may own the property where they need to pay a mortgage. They need to pay property taxes. That church needs your money to function. But that is giving money to the church, not giving money to God. Be careful when people come into your church and say, God told me that he needs you to give your money tonight. Especially folks that show up for a night and then disappear and you never see them again. God don't need your money. The church might need your money. The pastor might need your money. The ministry might need your money, but God don't need your money. God wants your worship. God wants your praise. God wants your faithfulness. But your little coins don't mean nothing to an omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent God. Like the video. Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.